As someone who skis all winter, I spend a lot of time in the snow. So I'm always checking forecasts, snow conditions, and of course, snow depth before heading out. But snow depth measurements are important for more than just recreation. They help researchers better understand the snowpack and hazards such as avalanches. And they also support water runoff models that inform us about water resources, ecology, tourism, and the effects of a changing climate. To learn more, I met up with two researchers for a ski tour and training session at Santiam Pass in Central Oregon. They taught me that anyone can measure and upload snow depth data with a few simple tools and techniques. Early one morning in February, we headed to the Santiam Snow Park, just across US 20 from Hoodoo Ski Resort. We met up with Nina Aragon and Dave Hill from Oregon State University.
Dave, how's it going, man?
Hey, Jim. Good to meet you.
Hey, likewise. Doing all right, Nina?
Nina is a PhD student studying water resource engineering. And Dave is a professor and one of the leaders of the NASA-funded Community Snow Observations Project.
So I'll start with Dave here. Tell us first and foremost what the Community Snow Observations Program is.
Right, so when we started this project, we wanted as many people as possible to be able to participate. And so we thought about keeping participation simple. So when it comes to measuring snow, there are many different things that you can measure, but snow depth is the easiest. So, you know, it could be done with anything, really. You can use a meter stick or a ruler. A lot of people who are traveling into the backcountry are carrying avalanche probes.
Got it. And Nina, what's kind of the upshot? What's the call to action for folks here if they want to get involved?
Really, the more data, the better. So we would like you to take data for us anywhere, anytime, because all of it is really useful for what we're doing and it can help to answer different types of science questions.
It was a cold morning, so we quickly put on our ski gear, grabbed our packs, and headed out. We skied along for a bit until Dave pointed out a flat spot where the snow was level and undisturbed, making it a good place to measure snow depth.
Well, you said a couple hundred more yards up this way?
I think so. Yeah.
All right, let's do it. Walk me through kind of what makes a good, you know, probe strike and what you're trying to do here, basically.
Okay, so first thing you're gonna do is assemble your probe, if that's what you're using as your measurement device. And then you wanna make sure that you're going straight perpendicular to the ground. So you wanna make sure your snow probe is very upright. And you're going to go down all the way to the ground. And it looks like we're at 200 again.
Once you take your measurement, all you have to do is enter it into the Mountain Hub app on your smartphone.
Report conditions, snow conditions.
It's important to log your measurement from the field, not your nice warm car, so your submission includes an accurate location. After recording our first observation, we continued on, looking for another good spot to stop.
So, you said kind of perpendicular to the slope, straight up and down.
Yep.
270, try it a little bit.
Yep.
Elsewhere on the slope here.
Yeah, so maybe take a few steps.
Cool.
Forward.
Ooh, hit ground earlier this time. That's distinctly ground, but maybe just a hair beneath, like 268.
Okay. Let's see.
So I've got my Mountain Hub app here.
Perfect.
I entered the data from our second observation, and we decided to seek one more spot to measure.
What I'm looking for. So you guys think maybe one more?
Yeah.
One more observation?
Yeah, that'd be great over here.
Cool.
What are you?
It's, I think.
A little deep.
It's a little deep.
Yeah.
It's a little too much.
Is your probe not long enough?
No, I'm not hitting ground.
So avalanche probes kind of come in different lengths, and if the one that you have is a little too short, we don't know how short it is. I mean, yeah. it could be way down, the ground could be way down there. But one thing we could try is I've got my avalanche shovel with me, is that I could dig a little bit of a pit so that we could see if we can get the probe down far enough. So
yeah, if you're willing to dig, I'm willing to get
I'm
set up here.
I'm willing to dig.
All right.
A little bit of time here.
Yeah, so Jim, I've kind of gone down probably meter and a half. I'm sorry, about a half meter or so.
Yeah.
And then when I pull this up, we just need to measure this extra distance from that mark to the surface. And to me, we got 180 to 190 there.
So
that's an extra 10 centimeters.
Yeah.
So 280 centimeters.
280.
After our third observation of the day, we headed back to the snowpark to warm up and debrief.
The great thing about backcountry snowshoers and snowmobilers and skiers and so forth is that they go to really high elevation areas. They go to complex terrain elevation areas. The information and the data that we get from people in those locations is really particularly valuable.
What do you folks do with this data once you're back, you know, in the classroom or in the lab, wherever it is you're working on this? Kind of what does this inform in a larger way?
What I'm working on with the modeling right now is actually getting all these observations that people submit, and I incorporate them into the model, and that helps us improve our estimates of snowpack distribution, especially in those locations, like Dave mentioned, in really complex terrain, so on top of mountains and in valleys and places where we don't have regular observations.
I like it. Well, you guys, thank you so much for coming out. It's been a lot of fun. I've learned some stuff, and I vow to, pull out that probe more often and submit some observations myself.
I've said that I want to become more active in contributing reports and observations to the mountain community, and this is a good step in that direction. Plus, observations like these help researchers simulate snow conditions and improve snow safety in the mountains. And that's a cause I can get behind.